Now, Mark Zuckerberg is spending hundreds of millions of dollars to interfere in our elections. Just today, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis touted the fact that his state has banned tech billionaires from influencing Florida's elections.
We banned Zuckerbucks. And so Zuckerberg, he spent over $400 million through these, quote, nonprofits to, quote, help with election administration. But what they would do is they would require certain things to be done, like mass mail balloting, ballot harvesting, these things, and they would focus on partisan voter turnout, basically. Elections should be administered by these offices, not by private tech moguls.
Well, exactly. So we knew that Zuckerberg spent close to $500 million on the last election, but until now we didn't have many details on what that money went to. Mollie Hemingway did the legwork on that. She's written a new book called Rigged, How the Media, Big Tech, and the Democrats Seized Our Elections. She joins us tonight to explain exactly what Mark Zuckerberg did in 2020. Mollie, congrats on the book. Thanks for coming on. And please tell us what Mark Zuckerberg did.
Thank you. Yes, in my new book, Rigged, I tell the story of how Mark Zuckerberg, who's one of the world's most powerful and wealthy men, funded the takeover of government election offices that are in charge of voter registration, voting, and vote counting. He spent nearly $500 million giving it to two left-wing groups that gave the money to governmental election offices, predominantly in Democrat cities in key swing states. And with those funds, they did targeted Democrat voter outreach, designing ballots, translating ballots, and staffing the operations that handled ballot harvesting, the curing of ballots, and the counting of ballots. And to be clear, this is not campaign spending. This was a concierge level get out the vote operation on behalf of Joe Biden and other Democrats in key Democrat areas in swing states. This is something that had never happened before, and this was done inside the election administration, not outside where billionaires normally spend their money.
Well, how are billionaires allowed to run our elections? I mean, as if they don't have enough power over our society.
Well, what's so amazing is, as Governor DeSantis noted, they had to make it illegal this year. It wasn't illegal when it was done because nobody ever imagined that tech oligarchs could control democracy by embedding left-wing activists into the election system. Even in states where people pay a lot of attention to this, like Wisconsin, they didn't even know really what was going on. And because they claimed these were nonpartisan, they didn't realize until it was too late that Democrat counties were getting the vast outside portion of the votes, and that it really made a difference in the final vote totals.
Boy, I wish the campaign that was running against Biden would have said more about this at the time. I mean, this seems like a massive scandal to me.
It's a massive scandal, but it actually took a while to realize just how targeted this was. This was very smart. It actually, there are people who researched in Texas. They say it gave Joe Biden a net of 200,000 votes. Now, that didn't mean that it made the difference in Texas, but that figure would make the difference in Wisconsin, Georgia, Pennsylvania, and Arizona.
Virtually every swing state. And I got to be honest, I didn't get it either until your book came out. So probably give them a pass on that.
Lots of details in there.
Exactly. Mollie Hemingway, thanks so much.
Thank you.